So today I'd like to show you what's on my iPad Pro and how I use it as a grad student. So this is the iPad Pro 2020, 11-inch. So this iPad came with the iPad pencil and also AirPods, which I actually sold just to get some money back. And then I bought the case separately for like $20. And altogether it costs around 1400 Canadian. So I just have one page to make it more minimal, and then everything is sorted into these folders. So the first one is school. And I have Zoom because every college student right now is in some sort of Zoom university. So that's obvious. And the second one is Notion. Notion's an app you use for basically organizing anything in your life. And I'm pretty new to it, so maybe it's not as beautiful as it could be, but I find it really nice. So this is like the main page. So I have like basically all my sub pages sorted into daily and more big picture, and there's a calendar. And for example, I have my goals. So here, it's a long-term goals, so things like far off in the future. And then I have goals I want to do by end of the month. And then going finer down, things I have to do this week. And then like day-to-day stuff. And it has some other features as well. So for my research, I really need to make myself look at the big picture more, and I created this board here which helps with that. So I kind of have big picture things, and it has it sorted in the to-do, doing, and done column, which is what they use on that show Silicon Valley. And then basically when I finish something, I just you can't drag it, but you click here and then you change it to the new status. And one thing that's really nice is it actually knows LaTeX. Here, like, this is all written in LaTeX, which is really convenient if you like math. And you can make all sorts of other things. So, for example, I have a reading list, so things that I want to read, which for me is mostly novels. And if I finish them or want to read them, currently reading them, again, you just click on the thing and here there's like the options. And I even have like a YouTube schedule where you can like view as a list or even like a calendar. So I really like this. I highly recommend. It's a free app, I'm pretty sure. So next is Good Notes. These notes are ugly. This one's a paid app, but it's like $12 or something like that. It's really worth it, I think. More or less, you just write your notes on it. You can insert pictures. Like, oh, there's a picture. So you can like cut out stuff from PDFs and paste it. Make it look really nice. You can also import PDFs and highlight stuff, which is really useful, I think. You can even write on it, like, to make yourself notes. And there's a lot more you can look into on GoodNote. I'm sure people have made videos about it. Next one's one of my favorite apps. It's Study Bunny. It's super cute. I have to move this. So this, I was just studying. So yeah, you set your timer. And if you do it, you get these coins. And then you can use the coins to buy your bunny stuff. I got her a blanket. You can put your violin down. Yeah. And it also like shows you how much you use the app, which is pretty good. And overall, very cute app. The next one here is Kanji. So this is for Japanese writing, and it just helps you learn kanji. So it shows you the kanji, the hiragana, what it means, and the pronunciation. And then it tells you what order to write these in. And the next tree I won't go into, so these just come with every iOS. And this is also a Japanese learning app, but I haven't used it in a while, so I don't want to speak to it really. Question is games. So my first game is New York Times Crossword. I'm obsessed with it. Basically every day you get a crossword. Unfortunately, it's a paid app. I don't remember how much it was, I'll put it here, but to me it's worth it because you get a crossword every day and I love them. And if you don't know, you can like turn this on and it tells you. So I got something. Oh, that's a past tense. Yeah, so it's like this. Next one is Tsuki's Adventures. He's eating ramen. Basically, you just follow this bunny around his life. It's like a relaxed game. And you just check out what he's doing. It's just very cute and relaxing. Okay. It's quite a good resolution. Third one is Neko Atsumi, which is an old app. And this one actually I made it in Japanese just to practice, but what you do is you just buy your cat some food. And they'll come in like, there's no cats here, unfortunately. Last one here is Sumiko Farm, which I haven't actually tried yet, I just got it, but these are the characters, Sumiko Gurashi. They're from San X, and I really like them, that's why I bought this. That's why I downloaded this game. Next I have just my TV stuff, so Netflix, of course. I'm in Canada, so CBC Gem has lots of TV shows and you can watch the news and stuff. And of course YouTube and Apple TV I never use, but it just came with this. So my next folder is social and video. So here I have Procreate. You guys know what it is, but I just use it for drawing. This is like a design, I think I'm allowed to show it now, that I drew for a t-shirt for summer school I went to. I'm actually happy how it turned out. And then some are like trash, some are not bad. Sometimes I use it to make thumbnails. I was trying to do like character design on it. This is also a paid app, but it was really cheap as well. And VLLO is a video editing app. So I'll just click on this one just to show you. But this is where I get the cute like stickers and stuff. So like it has a lot to choose from. That's why I like it. I like these cutesy kawaii things and it has a lot of that. Thank you. And you know, you can put frames and stuff. Very nice to me. YouTube Studio is just what if you have a YouTube channel, you can go in and look at your stuff. But to be honest, I usually go on the browser version of this because it's much nicer. Sell on Etsy. I closed my Etsy store because I keep having to travel back and forth away from my printer, so I won't go into that. And then Photos also just comes with iOS. LumaFusion's what I used to use to edit, but I like VLLO better, so I don't use it anymore, but it's not bad. Camera, obvious. iMovie just comes with the iPad, but to be honest, I don't think it's a very good editing software. It's like quite limited. Pinterest is what I use for drawing reference. And then these things, I don't know, they just come with the iPad. Then we have just things where you listen to podcasts. Again, CBC, because I'm in Canada, and it like lets you listen to the radio, and I really like this radio station, and Spotify. So that's what I've been listening to recently. So these four are probably my favorite four podcasts. If you watch a lot of YouTube, you probably know Remy and Alicia. They just talk about anything, life, YouTube, whatever, stuff you should know, teaches you stuff every day. It's quite useful. If you want to get good at trivia, it's a good podcast. This one's really interesting. I don't know if there's like a description, but basically they discuss things that are maybe taboo to ask and why is it like that. And it's by like a younger person and then an older dad who do it. And then this is two guys who just talk about pop culture stuff, games, movies, things like that. Tools, I just put like all this stuff that I consider a tool in one place, so it's more organized and not cluttering up my homepage. And then social, it's just the social things I have. And then Safari for browse. I did download this one, Quant, so it is supposed to like not track what you do, which is good. And another option if you want is DuckDuckGo. That's what I use like almost exclusively on my computer. I'm not sure if there's an iPad version. But yeah, that's what's on my iPad. It's Retsuko telling me to hustle hard, stop slacking. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. It helps out my channel a lot. If you have any like really good apps you'd like to share, feel free to comment them down below. And thank you for watching.